So, hello everyone. Today I want to talk to you how we organize extensions development process in our company. But first, let me please introduce myself shortly. My name is Igor Bondarenko, and I'm working in IT over 10 years. Last 2 years, I'm engaged in Magento development, and now I'm a head of business development in Neklo. What would I talking about today? I want to tell you how we organize a development process of extensions in order to reduce an overall costs and time of development. Also, I understand that it's really hard to change existing processes and start a new approaches. So, I split my speech for several parts, and today I want to tell you about how to choose an idea for development, how to specify and select good and powerful tools, how to prepare dev and test teams, and give some advices to developers. Also, here, I want to mention that we in our company don't make any differences between processes which take a part in development extension for sale and for custom development. All right, let's have a start from choosing of idea. I'm often asked, what extension to develop? And it's really a hard question, because I think it's really hard to predict if the extension will be successful on market or no. That's why we delegate this task to business development team. Business development team must analyze the current market situation, define critical user problems which must to be solved, and prepare a technical requirements for development. Then, these technical requirements bring it back to development team to estimate. And here you must to stop and think over if the cost of development satisfy you. If not, you must refuse this idea of commercial extension. And if that's custom development, I think you must find an analog, because now we have thousands and thousands of extensions for Magento, and if you have a look, I think you could find an analog for custom development. But if idea satisfy you, you must to develop it. But here I want to note, never delegate this task to choose an idea for developer, because developer will never analyze the market. He just select an idea which interested only for him from technical or some other points of view. Also, I understand that if you don't have business analysis and or business development team, and you don't have possibility to hire such specialists, you could delegate this task to quality assurance team. Because now a lot of team use agile approaches, and if you work by any agile practice like Scrum, Kanban, doesn't matter, your quality assurance team work like mediate between customer and development teams. They involve it in negotiation of business processes, technical processes, and the good solution is to teach your quality assurance team the basics of the business analysis and set this task to QA, guys. All right, you choose an idea. And in my practice, a lot of companies start working immediately, start development. But I think I strongly recommend to first specify a tools which you should use during development, because it's really hard to change a tool on development stage. In our company, we analyzed market and make a conclusion that we must develop some tools for us. And first, I want to introduce you some self-developed tools like Magento and Cloud VM servers. What's this? We have all of our extensions in Git, and we have a Cloud Virtual Machine server. integrated with Jenkins, and when development or quality assurance team needs some version of Magento, they just start a build on Jenkins. Jenkins create a new instance in Amazon, in cloud, and install a needed version of Magento and needed version of your extension to this server. And team immediately receive a ready for test or ready for development solution. This approach allows us to significantly reduce the time for environment preparation. Also, we developed a custom store extension. What does it mean? Sometimes for development or testing purposes, you don't need a clean store. You need a store with orders, with customers, and this extension allows you to create needed amount of customers, orders, reviews, doesn't matter. What should you do if you don't have a time to develop things like this? I think that you could use your quality assurance team again, because now test automation is very good solutions. You could just prepare test scripts which could install your extensions or prepare testing environments. Yes, it works longer, but you could just schedule these scripts for a night. It's not a problem. All right, what about tools available for all? First, don't forget to use any version control system. It's very bad when you have some extensions on one developer computer and another extension to other developer computer. If you use solutions like our Mage install, you must store all of your extensions in one place. Also, I recommend to use tools like developer toolbar or log popup. They allows you to view some additional request information, database request and time of the execution. You will receive information about new log records when they appears. Also, don't forget to turn developer mode on. Yeah, I understand that the most of you use developer mode on, but in Magento 2, it's, on my point of view, almost impossible to make something with Magento in production mode. If you forgot to switch to developer mode, you will have a lot of errors during development, so don't forget this. All right, you specify tools, it's time to create a team, to build a team which could work under an extension. In our company, we came to the conclusion that the most advantageous process is when highly specialized experts engaged in development. So, in our company, Magento developers work only with backend and admin panel parts. All front-end tasks doing our front-end developers. And also, we have a system administrators team which deals with configurations, databases, servers. At the first glance, it looks like one-way ticket to increase overall cost of development. But in our practice, this approach allows us to significantly reduce overall time of development and in total decrease overall cost of development. And I also understand that it's not always possible to create a big team for extension development. So now I want to tell you how we work if we have a team or we have only one developer working with extension. If you have a team, first, I think you must specify a team lead, a person who will decompose the tasks, delegate these tasks to developer team members, and control over the execution. Also, it's a good idea to split the Magento version by the developers. For example, if you have two developers, first, start working with lowest supported Magento version, for example, 1.4. And the second developer work with highest supported version, for example, 1.9. And time to time, they merge their codes and check how it works all together. And if you have a team only from one developer, it's a good idea to start working with the lowest supported version at Magento and time to time check how this solution works on the highest versions. And develop your extension sequentially. Start implementation from backend part, then prepare admin part, and in the last order work with frontend. All right, what about Magento 2? I think that the key point of my view that overall time, speed, and cost of development will not change when you work with Magento 2. I understand that it sounds tricky because you developers must have a time to look for Magento 2. And good solution from my point of view is start not from development from scratch, but start migration your already existing extension from Magento 1 up to Magento 2. But here I want to prevent you from one big error. Don't start from migrating most valuable or most profitable extension. Start from the simplest solution. That's how your dev and test teams have a practice with Magento 2, look for it, have some experience, and when your team receives this experience, only after this start to migrate more complicated solutions. Next slide, I think, will be a boring slide for developers. You could prepare your smartphones because our development team prepare a document for you which contain main differences between Magento 1 and Magento 2. It's related with extension development. So it's if interesting for you, you could scan this QR code and given access to this document. So I don't see a phone small, so I will continue. I want to continue with another problem, compatibility with third-party extension. That's a really big risk when you develop it an extension. If you want to obtain compatibility with all of third-party extension, I think it's almost impossible because you need a lot of time to test this. But I want to give you some advices how to minimize these risks. First of all, from development point of view, use integration through the events and don't use rewrites. Rewrites is a bad practice and try to avoid this. What about quality assurance team? I think that's a good idea if you want to check compatibility with third-party extension is to test compatibility with top-rated or most viewed extension from Magento Connect. What else we use in our processes? First of all, the good practice is using of code review or pair programming. This approach allows us to significantly increase the external quality of our products because it allows our junior specialists to look for a code of senior specialists and have a look for good practices, good approaches for code style, for using of methods on something else. And when senior specialists look for a code of junior specialists, he could prevent some defects on development stage. All right, when you finish development, it's time to test an extensions. In our company, we never put the testing of extensions to the shoulders of our end customers. We always include QA specialists in the development team. How it works in our company? When development stage is over, our developers switch the tasks and don't work with this extension while testing, while the first iteration of testing. Only after QA team stops the testing and finds all of defects, our team fixes defects, and from the starting from the second iteration of testing, both teams works close together. What also could be useful in this process? to increase quality. I think test automation is a very good idea for extensions. It allows you to avoid some things like regression testing. It could help you to install your extensions to test environment. But here I want to prevent you from using complex frameworks like Selenium WebDriver or maybe QTP or something like this. Because most of times, extension development is a short-term activity. And overall ROI of this automation using complex frameworks will be a negative. Personally, I recommend you to use simple and lightweight frameworks like Selenium IDE or SpiderTest. Why? At first, it's free and simple solutions. Every person from team could just record steps and then run the steps when it needed. In our company, we use an approach. If QA specialist find a defect and put them to Jira, he also record steps of this reproduction and attach this script to a bug. And when developer fix them, he first run this test and ensure that he really fix the problem. He never push a version which not tested by him. These tools allow us to do this. When you finish the testing, it seems that you are ready for release. But don't you really forgot nothing? Many teams, I think, forgot testing readiness of your extension to Magento Connect. Time to time, I get situation when I try to install extension, new extension from Magento Connect, and it doesn't install because developer forgot to include some files in package. For my point of view, you must create a package and then send this package to QA team in order to ensure that all files appear in this extension, in this package. Then upload your package for Magento Connect, wait for approve and install extension. If it works fine, start to promote it. And in conclusion, I want to specify key success factors which allows us to build a really exciting process of Magento extension development. First of all, we always perform a business analysis before starting the development. Also, we think over and prepare tools, test and dev environments before we start development. We use high-skilled specialists engaged in development, and we never forgot about the testing. Thank you for your attention. Your questions?